quelqu'un d'autre. Hein?
There's our pal, Cervantes. Give him a nice thank you wave, everybody.
Thank you!
Madre mía. Is it him?
Ugh, where did all this horrible fog come from? I can't see a thing.
Hey, Sylph, what's going on?
I'm truly mystified.
But whatever it is, I don't like it. Steering hard a starboard!
The mists are clearing. I can see light up ahead.
Where in the world are we?
Thank you.
What a strange place. It's almost like being in a dream.
Oh, darling, is it really you? My dearest darling, Kai? I've waited for you ever since the day we said goodbye. Oh, ah. Oh. Hey! What do you think you're playing at, scaring us like that? And there's no need to look so disappointed to see us. Hold on. Are you, That's strange. You didn't scream or try to catch me in a net. You're different from most other human beings that I've met. My name's Michelle. I'm sorry if I gave you all a fright. It's just I thought my car was back and I got all excited. Wow. I can't believe I'm talking to a real-life mermaid. But anyway, who's this Kai you keep talking? He's a tender-hearted fisherman from Lonalulu Bay. He promised he would meet me here upon our wedding day. Your wedding day? I didn't even think humans and mermaids could get married. At first, I was the same. I thought we'd never be together. I thought the mermaid's burden would keep us apart for if a mermaid leaves the sea and makes the land her home, if ever she gets wet again, she melts away to foam. But when I told my Kai I couldn't come to live with him, he said, "In that case, Shell, you better teach me how to swim." And so I got the blessing of the Queen Beneath the Sea. He's going to come to Nautica and live down there with me.
Oh, that's wonderful news. Congratulations.
But he's supposed to meet me here so we can be together. And I've been waiting for him now for what feels like forever. I know he'd never break his word. He's not that sort of person. But the longer that he stays away, the more my worries worsen. I know it's rude to ask you, but I beg, I plead, I pray. Could you go to Lonalulu and make sure my Kai's okay?
So you're from the bottom of the sea, where the giant pearl from the story went. I wonder... How about this? If we go and check on your fiancé, will you take us down to see the Queen?
To pay for such a kindness, it's the least that I can do. I'll sing my song and safely sink your ship and all your crew.
If anyone knows the truth about this giant pearl, it's the Queen of the Sea. If it leads us to another one of the orbs, it's worth helping, wouldn't you say?
Thank you, all of you. I'd be indebted to you if you could try to find him in the town of Lonalulu. I'll mark the village on your map. It's to the east of Hotto, a beautiful blue bay behind an isolated grotto. My Kai is a famous fisherman, as ragged as the ocean. A hanky-janky sailor stuffed with smouldering emotion. Oh, now I'm all embarrassed. Don't tell him what I said. Just bring...
else wants some?
Wonderful.
Thank you.
just keep getting better.
Thank you. sí.
Beautiful Honolulu, a seaside paradise that Shell tells me is home to the prettiest pearls in all the world.
Pearls!
Bright blue waves, pure white sands, and fabulous jewels just lying on the beach. Truly, darlings, this is the promised land. Seem a little less promising than I expected. Where is everybody?
Something's not right here. Still, it's not our problem. Let's just find this Kai guy and get out of here.
Meow.
quello è tuo dito. Lo sogniamo.
Look, Auntie's here. The show's about to begin. Are you all paying attention? Good. Then I'll tell you the tale of the terrible curse that befell our village long ago. The curse of a crafty creature with a face as pretty as a pearl, but a heart. Once upon a time, a master fisherman lived in Lanalulu. The mayor of Lanalulu, the big kahuna, was very fond of this fisherman and offered him the hand of his beloved. The fisherman and the kahuna's daughter agreed to be married. Until the day of the storm. The fisherman was caught up in a terrible tempest. As he sank through the water, he saw the pearls he had gathered shining like stars all around him. The light faded, and he prepared to meet his mate. But instead, he met her, a mermaid more beautiful than any creature he had seen before. She held him in her arms and whispered in his I will give you your life if you give me your soul. Many days passed and the fisherman did not return. The people of the village thought him dead and held a funeral for him on the beach. But just as they were beginning to sing his soul into the next world, he appeared, exhausted but alive. The kahuna's daughter was overjoyed to have her beloved home and stayed by his bedside night and day, nursing him back. But the fisherman was no longer the man she knew. All day he would stare out to sea, muttering over and over, "I must marry that mermaid." Then one day, he threw his fiancée aside and ran to the harbor screaming, "I must go back to her!" He banished the fisherman from the village and burned his boat so he could never set sail. And so, the man who was once the pride of Lonalulu spent the rest of his days alone on Saikiki Beach, haunted by the mermaid who stole his soul. That's all for today, children. I'll tell you the rest of the story tomorrow.
Mermaids are scary!
Aloha, friends.
Maybe. We're looking for a fisherman called...
Oh, my! What a coincidence! You must be looking for my son, Kainui. Are you friends of his? I'm afraid he's not here at the moment. All the men have sailed west to fight the giant squid that's been attacking our ships. If you want to hurry things along, maybe you could go lend a hand. Once that monster's dealt with, they'll all come back to the village, sure enough. But be wary, friends. That squid isn't the only danger out on the seas. Don't let a crafty mermaid make you all pupule. I'd hate to see you go crazy.